This week on The Box, we preview the 2017 NLL season opener as the Nighthawks get set to host The Rock on Thursday night.
We then head west on the I-90 as the Bandits host the Mammoth in their opener on Friday night.
And we caught up with the Buffalo Bandits to see how last year's Champions Cup final exit has inspired them heading into 2017.
Don't move a muscle. It's all coming on this week's edition of The Box Pregame Show. And welcome to this episode of The Box. Mia Gordon and Tyson Geick here from NLL Productions, getting you ready for face-off weekend. That's right, the 2017 season is officially here.
Yeah, preseason is in the books, and the quest for the Champions Cup will officially begin on Thursday night as the Rochester Nighthawks get set to host the Toronto Rock at the Blue Cross Arena.
So without any further ado, let's get into that game preview. The 2017 NLL season kicks off Thursday night as the Rochester Nighthawks welcome the Toronto Rock, both teams with something to prove after failing to make it to the playoffs last year. A lot of new faces on both sides of the ball as the teams focus on building in this year's draft. For the Rochester Nighthawks, the motto was faster and stronger, and rookies like Kyle Jackson and Josh Currier came up big in the preseason. For the Toronto Rock, they went 3-0 in preseason action thanks to the likes of newcomer Mikey McDonald and the return of some injured key members like Brett Hickey. Can they keep up the momentum as regular season gets underway? We find out Thursday, December 29th, 7:30 p.m.
Tyson, both of these teams missed the playoffs last year. They both have something to prove this upcoming season. So in your first two-minute drill, let's talk about this matchup.
Two very different-looking teams are going to be taking the floor to start the 2017 season here, Mia. And let's start with the Toronto Rock. They wanted to get younger in the offseason. They wanted to get stronger, and I think they've done that. They've got six new faces on that roster, five of whom will be making their NLL debuts in 2017. Mikey McDonald, the only member of those six who has any NLL experience, having played a couple of games with the New England Black Wolves last season. So I like the changes that Toronto has made in getting a lot younger. The guys like Dan Littner and Mikey McDonald stepped up in the preseason and have proved that they could be guys that Toronto can rely on this season. And I'm excited to see what happens with them. Then we move to the Rochester Nighthawks. 10 new faces on this roster, which is crazy. A really revamped roster here. You got guys like Jared Davis and Andrew Suter coming in, two NLL vets. Davis having won a couple of Champions Cups with the Rush organization. And the team looking a lot younger as well, adding players through the draft. Kyle Jackson, Josh Currier, both having very successful preseasons, coming up huge for their team. And I'm going to really be looking at these guys to see what they can do for their respective teams in this home opener here.
We've spoken about some of the new faces on the Toronto Rock, but some faces that we will be missing. Last year, the Rock had to deal with a lot of injuries, and it seems still the case in 2017.
Yeah, Rob Hellier is one of the players that Toronto is really going to be missing this season. He's going to miss the entirety of the 2017 regular season, recovering from ACL surgery. So that is a tough loss for the Toronto Rock, arguably their best player. But they're going to have to learn how to live without him. And if they can add a player like this in the postseason, it's just going to mean good things. They're really going to have to come together as a unit, learn how to play without him. But you get a guy like that back, and you're going to be enthralled.
Speaking of the Rochester Nighthawks, two players that you mentioned, Kyle Jackson and Josh Currier, both going in the first round of this year's draft, both having very successful preseasons. But are they ready for the big stage?
I think they are ready for the big stage, and I think they proved that in the preseason. Kyle Jackson led the way in terms of scoring for the Rochester Nighthawks. He came up with 13 points in the preseason. Very impressed with his performance. And then Josh Currier, 6 goals and 1 assist over the course of just 2 games. So these guys are ready for it, and I think they're being kind of pushed into it really fast, but I think they're up for the challenge here. And for Kyle Jackson, he has no choice but to be strong for the Nighthawks. With Cody Jamison and Corey Vitterelli out, two veteran players, both lefties, Kyle Jackson is really going to be relied upon to be more of a force on that left-hand side. So let's sum up the points here, Mia, in my 2-minute drill recap.
For the Toronto Rock, they've got a new product on the floor. 5 players on the Rock will make their NLL debuts in 2017. And the team will also be without offensive superstar Rob Hellier for the entire regular season, as he's still recovering from surgery. Dan Lintner and Mikey McDonald had notable preseasons, and the Rock need them to keep up that play. And for the Rochester Nighthawks, 10 new faces on the Rochester Nighthawks roster, 5 of whom were signed as free agents in the offseason. Veterans Cody Jamison and Corey Vitarelli both start the season on the IR. For Jamison, there's no timeline on his return. In their absence, Kyle Jackson needs to step up and perform the way he did in the preseason.
Face-off weekend continues in Buffalo as the Champions Cup finalists, the Buffalo Bandits, welcome the Colorado Mammoths. So let's take a look at the game preview.
Face-off weekend continues in Buffalo as the Champions Cup finalists, the Bandits, get things underway against the visiting Colorado Mammoth. They will rely heavily on veteran leaders like Ryan Benesch and reigning MVP Dane Smith. But the Colorado Mammoth are also a 2016 playoff team that has a lot of their veteran leaders returning to the lineup. A team with a strong defense led by goaltender of the year finalist Dylan Ward, they are tough to get through. Who will come out on top? We find out Friday, December 30th, 7:30 p.m.
Tyson, as mentioned, Buffalo making it to the finals last year, but not coming out on top. So in this 2-minute drill, I want to start off with what the Bandits maybe learned from the 2016 season.
Well, they gained a lot of experience from that season, but they learned that they can't just rely on the likes of guys like Dane Smith and Ryan Benesch. They need to get scoring from more players, really. They had a successful season last year overall, though. We can't just focus on the Champions Cup final. Throughout the regular season, they set a franchise high in terms of wins with 13. That's great for them. And then they were 8-1 at home. So the Colorado Mammoth are going to have their work cut out for them in Banditland to start the season here.
You speak of Dane Smith. All eyes will be on him, but also some other veteran players to keep a look at.
Yeah, absolutely. And I mentioned Ryan Benesch. Brad Self and Craig Point, 2 veteran players added in the offseason for the Buffalo Bandits. And then you got guys like Mark Stainhouse, one of the flashiest players in the league, the most entertaining guys to watch on the floor. So I think Buffalo is going to be poised for another Champions Cup run here in 2017.
We've spoken about Buffalo's offense. Let's take a look at Colorado's defense, though. This team allowed the second least amount of goals against last season. Thanks to the help of goaltender of the year finalist Dylan Ward, can they keep that up?
I think they can. I'm looking at Dylan Ward to continue his performance into 2017. He was great last season, led the league in terms of save percentage. So defensively, the Colorado Mammoth are looking really good. So let's recap these points in my 2-minute drill recap.
For the Buffalo Bandits, there's high expectations for this team. Last year, they set a franchise record with 13 wins, and they were absolutely deadly at home. In the offseason, they acquired Brad Self and Craig Point. We're going to see how they fare this season. And all eyes will be on the great Dane, who had a 137-point season last year. We're going to see how he follows that up. For the Colorado Mammoth, the team is looking very similar to the team that took the floor last season. Zach Greer is one new addition to the team, and the Colorado Mammoth will need goal scoring out of him. Dylan Ward had the highest save percentage in the league last year, while Callum Crawford led the league in assists, and I want to see solid follow-up performances from them.
The Buffalo Bandits are coming off a successful season that saw them in the Champions Cup Finals. But unfortunately for them, they couldn't get past the Saskatchewan Rush. This year, it's Champions Cup or bust, according to the team. We caught up with them to find out what they learned from 2016 and what they're looking forward to in 2017 in this week's Outside the Box. The Buffalo Bandits kick off their season this weekend at home against the Colorado Mammoth. We caught up with some members of the team to find out how the Champions Cup final last year has inspired them for 2017.
That's it! Your winners and still National Lacrosse League champions are the Saskatchewan Rush!
It's something that didn't sit very well with us, myself personally too. You know, it's a stinging feeling, and it's something that you know, only fuels your fire to make you want to play better and do better.
It's tough to bounce back from that loss, but like I said, it's in the past, and we're looking forward to this year. We want to make it that far again.
2016 was a dream year for the Buffalo Bandits as they found themselves in the Champions Cup final for the first time in 80 years. But it was a season that ended in heartbreak as they fell to the Saskatchewan Rush in two games.
We know we're right there. We always believed how good we are, but kind of getting to the finals, and for myself, it was the first time being there, and other guys getting to play in that, you gain experience. And we realized we were, I think it was 2 or 3 goals away. So it's not too many changes will be needed. I think we're ready to go on another run.
That loss has been a motivator for the team in the offseason.
It's championship or bust this year. I mean, it's something we can definitely build on, but we are nowhere near satisfied with that result.
After a strong training camp, they are ready to step out in front of Banditland and get the 2017 season underway.
It's just pure excitement. Our fans are by far the best in the league, and I wouldn't want to play anywhere else.
It's been a long time coming since last year. Think about it all through the summer and all through training camp. So just excited to be here. Can't wait to see our fans again.
Believing it is just small changes that will make big differences.
Just working as a team. I think we came together. We were really tight last year. It was like the tightest family we've had yet. So I think coming together, doing a lot of team bonding stuff, and obviously working hard on the floor, doing those little things.
I mean, I don't think we got to change a whole lot from last year. We did make the finals. I mean, it's just a matter of executing our game plan and coming out every night.
Differences they are hoping that will see them hoisting the cup this year.
Fans, you can catch this game and all games all season long. All you have to do is subscribe to NLLTV.com today. For NLL Productions, I'm Mia Gordon. That wraps up this episode of The Box. Don't forget the 2017 season underway December 29th. Tyson, you're hitting the road, right?
I will be at those games. Be sure to follow along with my journey and experiences at the season opener and then at Buffalo's home opener as well by following along with the NLL social accounts at the NLL, of course.
And if you can't be at the games but want to make sure you don't miss any of the action, well, it's easy. All you have to do is subscribe to NLLTV.com today, and you can catch all your favorite teams, all of their games, all season long.
For Mia Gordon, I'm Tyson Geick. Thanks for tuning in to this week's episode of The Box. We'll see you next time, folks.